Don't call me up today is my mood. Singing, definitely, always. Tiesto, obviously, because we have a song together. Hey guys, I'm Mabel. Do you want to see more of Release Reactions? If you do, then become a subscriber of 538 YouTube channel and let us know in the comments who you want to see in the next episode. So this is Ed Sheeran, South of the Border, featuring Camila Cabello and Cardi B, but it's the Cheat Codes remix. Oh my God, this isn't gonna work with my hat. I never heard that remix before. I love the song, like the original. But yeah, I like that remix a lot. It was like good dance vibe. Yeah, I love Ed Sheeran. I always have. Like, I've been a fan since his like first album. He's amazing. I'd love to like actually write with him as well. Like, he's an amazing songwriter. So I've met him once. Yeah, I met him quite recently, actually. He's a really nice guy. Jump in that water, be free, come south of the border with me. I haven't really been at home a lot this year because like Don't Call Me Up came out in January and we've been like traveling a lot since then. But when I am at home, I like to spend time with my family. My mom cooks, that's the best thing. My mom cooks, we just spend time at my mom's house. I have a very loud family, just like cracking jokes, chilling. I actually really like days off on tour. That they can be like really funny because last year when I was on tour with Harry Styles, we had a day off in Bologna, and that's in Italy, and I'd never been before, but like, it's such a cool place, and like we had amazing food, and my friends flew in from London, like two of my best friends, and we had like probably one of my favorite days of last year, just like running around the city. We got on like one of those like tourist like hop on, hop off buses. I'd never done that before. It was so much fun. Okay, this is Marco Borsato, Snell, John Eubank, Lippenstift, and it's called Lippenstift. Is that lipstick? I don't know what you're saying, but it sounded very heartfelt and emotional. Working with Tiesto is just like such an honor. I've always wanted to like make a dance record, and obviously being able to make a dance record with like the best in the game is pretty cool. Wat will die sein Lemans Gelüfte auf sein Grutste Geheim? Is that what they're saying in that song? Oh my God. It has a very deep meaning. I knew it. I could feel it in the emotion. Oh no, I'm a pretty bad actress and liar. But I can keep secrets. Okay, so it's French Montana, Writing on the Wall, featuring Post Malone, Cardi B, and Russian? Excellent crew of artists. Made me want to dance. It's a great song. Cardi B. I love Cardi B. She's amazing. Call my accountant, bought my bitch a new Beamer. She whips 7 Series. I spend whatever. Girl, I do whatever to show you I'm serious. I don't drive, I can't drive. I don't have my license. Because I signed my record deal when I was like 18, and then it's literally like I haven't had a week off in a row. Right now I get driven. Oh, my favorite present ever was like my family, like my sisters and my brother and my mom and my dad and my auntie got me these like really cute Chanel earrings, which I wear all the time. I'm very generous for sure. And I actually like, I enjoy buying presents for people. I think it's about like buying something that somebody's gonna use a lot and like where they feel like, oh, you've made an effort, you've really thought about this, like rather than it being expensive. Diplo, Jonas Brothers, Lonely. Everybody needs a place to hide. This don't have to be a bumpy ride. I think we should be alone tonight. Cause we don't have to be lonely. Such a feel good moment. I do like the Jonas Brothers. I was like proper fangirling last year. They went like on a radio station back home and they asked them about like new music or somebody that they like, and they started singing Don't Call Me Up on the radio, and somebody tagged me and I saw it on Instagram. I was like, no way, I'm dead. I think you should be alone with me because we don't have to be lonely. Yeah, everybody feels lonely sometimes, no? I think traveling sometimes, like even that's like my favorite thing. I do get like homesick sometimes and I miss my parents and I'm like, I feel lonely. I don't think about it like that at all. I think I've had to work just as hard as anybody else, you know? I think your parents being somebody can only get you to a certain point. Like, I don't think it's made it harder or easier. It was just like a different type of journey, I think. No, we don't sing together. It's literally just like normal things that families do. We'll watch movies together. Sometimes they come to my house. Like, if I'm lucky, I can like convince my dad to take some of my washing. Stuff like that, or like be like, Dad, can you drive me to blah 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 blah. Okay, well, this is Susan and Freak. Ah, with the Dutch pronunciation. I'm so sorry to everybody in the Netherlands. This is so embarrassing. Okay, Mag Ik. Do you say Ik? Da. Even still by Stan. Also very emotional. I do, oh my God, I love an emotional song. I'm a Pisces, see, I'm very like in tune with my emotions, very much into crying every now and again whilst listening to a sad song. I think it's good, it's healthy. Coldplay, always Coldplay when I'm sad. Like every breakup I've ever been through, I just like lie on the floor and listen to Fix You. I think it's like the best, you know, sometimes when you're sad and you just want to listen to sad music, like it doesn't make any sense because you should like want to listen to happy music, but like I'll listen to like Yellow, Fix You, Warning Sign. Als ik u nooit had gevonden, kon ik de liefde denk ik niet aan noem mij maar emotional of bijzonder mag ik daar even stil bij staan. Sometimes people are like, do you know like what's happened this year? Have you like taken it all in? And I'm like, oh. Yeah, so it's actually one of my like weaknesses because I'm always like thinking about the future. I kind of forget sometimes to like enjoy what's happening now, I guess. So like at the end of last year, I did my biggest ever headline show and that was like amazing. That's definitely one of the moments where like in the moment, I was like, this is crazy because you're looking out and seeing like thousands of people, whereas like even just a couple years ago, it was only a few hundred. So it's pretty cool.